down to 3%. But it should.
No! Back it up! Back it up! Fail!
But this is a control panel too.
A GM rear light socket.
Wait.
Oh fuck, did we not pay that bill too? Guys, welcome to today's Captain's Blog. It's 11:58 hours on Friday, May 30th, 2014. This is Josh.
Hello.
Josh is awesome because as of this morning, we are working with everybody. I'm not going to do the name dropping thing, but we had meetings today with like just all kinds of people and it's awesome. We're looking at a 200-acre project. We're looking at just a lot of stuff. The news of things that's happening here is about to get way cooler in a very big way, and I'm not going to tell you about any of it, so don't even ask until it's official. Once we close on property, then you know about the property. Once we have the grant, then you know about the grant. But I can tell you that it's pretty awesome working at the Geek Group today. And it's entirely the fault of this man, who is a rock star.
We're trying.
Josh Spencer, IRC. Development rock star.
Cool things coming.
Yep, it's good. So that's what's up. Instead of getting to hear about senators and governors and all that stuff, you guys get to see really awesome new paint lines. And this man, who last night had sex with a rooster. So, that's what's up. And Dale's here, who I have to talk to. I'll be back in a minute.
Yeah.
All right, guys, time is 13:04 hours, and it's time for viewer mail. What do we got?
We got a little box.
Chris Bowden, Kara Harvey points. It's from Yummy Electronics. So you know it's a good time. Harvey is making threatening noises that he might be coming here soon.
Yay!
I think that's pretty awesome. It's a Leatherman. Which one is it? Oh! Harvey replaced the Leatherman that I lost. Thank you, sir! By the way, you should know that yesterday, Doogie found the Leatherman that I lost, so I have a backup. But thank you, sir. It's not like we don't give a lot of them away, so. Geek Group member donations. It's from Jeremy Swink. I know that asshole. Where is he? This dude. Have you seen his hair? He had sex with a rooster last night.
He's about to cut it.
I get to do something I've never done before. This would be fun. Jeremy, come here, man. So you sent in a note.
I had a note.
I had a note.
You told me I couldn't put it in.
Well, if it doesn't have a note, it just says you drew your gift. You get to hang your note on the wall. So what did he send? Arduino Leonardo with headers?
Yes!
And another Arduino Leonardo with headers.
Yay!
Yes. Go. And send no more.
Awesome.
I gotta share this with you guys. This is going to piss off a ton of people, and they are all the people that need pissing off. Isn't that great? It's gonna piss off half the planet. And to the half of the planet who finds this deeply, viscerally offensive, I would simply like to convey, you can eat a dick.
I don't.
And I mean that in the truest, most literal, sincere sense of the word.
I don't get it.
Well, it means that there's a lot of rar in the news over people that are refusing service or refusing various things to various people because they're gay.
Oh.
And they're overlooking.
They're overlooking
the fundamental thing that surpasses religious views and political views and all that. They're overlooking one fundamental fact. They're fucking people. And I have a problem with that. So, yeah. Viewer mail, the Geek Group doesn't. Oh, it's from Dale.
The box says it's from Spider-Man.
Look at the stamp.
It does have Spider-Man on the side.
Look at the stamp.
The stamp?
American clock. Okay?
He dropped them off in person and he gave us 20 cents in postage.
Because the stamps are canceled. Okay. Dear Chris, here are some things I hope you find interesting. Look at the brevity in text. Why can't I get him like this in speech? One circuit board to be used for recycled, one display board note the 3 farad capacitor on the back. The smallest vacuum tube I could find without opening up a TV tuner. A belt recorder for autopsy. The empty case might make an interesting geek purse if refinished. Okay, now I'm frankly curious. Okay, we have a circuit board. Note the 3 farad capacitor on the back. Are you dying?
Not yet.
Okay, I don't... There we go. 5.5 volts, 3.3 farads. That's a 5 volt, 3 farad capacitor. That is cool as hell. I want to have the largest farad rating capacitor anybody can send in on display. Yeah!
Oh, yeah.
That's big enough to be a belt.
Yeah.
That'd
be funny every morning. You got your grill with the nut driver.
Now don't say that, because now there's going to be a vine of some kid at home going, "Shrek, Mom, Mom."
I hurt more than a zipper.
The worst part is carrying a ratchet set with you if you had to poo.
Why am I trying to do this in my thumbnail when I got a little thumbnail? Look at this. Okay, guys, what kind... I'm going to see if I can find markings on it. What kind of vacuum tube is this? It has 4 wires, and it looks like that. Can you identify that vacuum tube? A belt recorder. This is... a Stenocord 500, and it is a belt recorder, and you know everything that I... Oh no! Come here, take a look. Whoa, hang on. Can you get that? Now on the back, there's a couple plugs. One is labeled car, 6 volts DC. Main, 110, 220, 50 to 70 cycles a second. I'm very interested in this. Teach me about it. But put this on autopsy. It's got a handle. It's designed for that. Put that on autopsy.
6 volts for the car. So any car before 1960?
More files for finishing 3D printed projects. Oh, they're files. Because it's an envelope of files. I was like, okay, that's cool. No, it's not. It's not those kind of files. It's files. Like bastard files. Like rat tail files. Those aren't files, those are tweezers. Okay. Thank you, Dale. I needed these a month ago. A month ago. Spirit of Sports from Zappos. Who sent it?
There's a note.
Huh?
There's a note.
There's a note. There's a note. Anthony Barclay. Looks like a film canister.
It is.
What kind of a film canister? Is there film in it?
No.
Are you sure? Let's look. No, there's film in it.
It was sold empty.
I'm taking your picture right now. Years ago, hi Boars! I was in a printing graphic arts class. And we used to have a door to the dark room that was, it was a revolving door, but it was a really cool type of revolving door. Imagine a cylinder with an opening here, an opening here, and inside that cylinder was another cylinder that had an opening on one side. So you'd step in, you'd turn it around, and you'd walk through. So light could only be at one door at a time. It made a really cool sound. I watched an idiot, Adam Buzzolini is his name, come out of the room holding a sheet of film that was about this big, okay, for the process camera. He had in his hand a piece of orthochromatic CPN film, copy-proof negative, from Agfa. It's good stuff. He walks out of the dark room, through the door, into the main classroom, and says, "Is this the film I use?" To which everybody went, "Yeah!" 5 minutes later, he comes out.
It's all black. I don't want
it. Muppets.
That's for the pinhole camera project.
Oh, it's for the pinhole.
Well, not that one.
I just opened this box. I swear to Christ, if I open one of these and it's full of spiders.
Send spiders, dude.
This one's got more presidents on it. Stamps. Okay, I'm gonna do this for legit. Doesn't have spiders, but it has a tiger. Max RPM, blank. You figure it out.
So many digits, we couldn't fit it on the
wall. Let us know when it explodes. And we've got... someone stealing a little standoffish. And more rat tail files. And really long Allen wrenches. Paper. Drill bits that are not yet dull. Give it 5 minutes. Drill bits. Number 10. 25,000 RPM grinding discs. Cutoff discs. Handles. Allen wrenches. And note, here are some things I hope you find useful that I found at the surplus sale. A handle with a lock set. This should go to Harvey. That's a nice handle. This should go to Harvey Points. ATC timer for autopsy. Press the blue button all the way down to set the time.
That's neat.
That's going to be a nifty autopsy. I like it. Buttons and lights. Really big buttons and lights. I want to know what this was a control panel to. A GM rear light socket.
Wait.
Oh, fuck. Did we not pay that bill too?
All right, let's double check and see if somebody hit a switch.
Were you rolling when the lights went out?
Yeah.
All right, it's now 13, 17 hours. Lights came back on after like 30 seconds, but we have a robot. Alright, Scott and editor, do a walk downstairs, check the boiler room, check all the stuff, make sure nothing's freaking out. You go do a walk upstairs, just looking for smoke, fire, sparks, anything that freaked out.
Cross 3!
I think it was hooligans again?
No, I think it went out for everything and then came right back up. I don't think it was new. No, we put locks on it.
Oh, so it can't be new.
Hey, Mike?
Yeah?
Bring the Haas machines back up. Make sure they're safe.
How did we lose both types of power?
Did we lose 480? The Haas machines went down. Did Batman install the padlocks on the things outside?
Yeah, nothing looked weird.
Were they locked? Are there padlocks on them?
Yeah, I think so. Well, I don't know how many you put on, but it looked normal.
Let's take a look. Where's my car? Where's my shades? Where's my shades that were on top of my car?
With your bag.
Where am I?
Yesterday.
With my bag. Yeah, where's the shades? Oh, the shades are in the car?
Yep, sorry.
It's alright. Find out where the hell you put my car. You asshole. Did you lock both sides? Oh god, you dick. He locked my car.
I locked your car since it was outside.
Who locked my car?
I did. I don't want anything stolen from inside.
Would you steal that car?
Not the car, but
oh, okay. I don't have anything that valuable.
I don't think that would you steal that car are going to sell.
Why?
Because they stole the last one.
Okay, that is a fair point, but I'd like to point out that the car that they stole is parked right over there. You know why? Because I got it back. So steal my car, assholes. I'll get it back. I'll get my car back and your ass is going to jail. And not even the good jail, not the fun jail from like Wolf of Wall Street, but you're going to federal pound you in the ass prison. Stealing my car. What is this?
I heard Patrick and Mark downstairs.
That's Patrick, and I'll bet Mark's right behind him. Look at that. There's Patrick and Mark and Twink and Ed.
Wow.
And Scott. What are you guys having? Like the.
There is a breaker downstairs that's tripped.
Is a breaker that's tripped? Okay, well you can't turn that off. Can't turn that off. This one needs to be drilled for a thing. This is 480 volt feeds panel.
I don't remember.
Did we lose 120 power throughout the entire building?
How the lights?
We lost 120 power in AV, but did we lose 120 power in the whole building?
I lost it down in electronics.
To my understanding, it was the entire building. Josh's computer was off, for example, when we walked
past. Then what happened wasn't here, because if we lost 120 in AV, you'd lose that if we lose 480, because that feeds to 120 in AV. But if we lost all the power throughout the entire building, that means that consumers lost mains power
somewhere
up on the high line, because our 480 and our 120 and our 240 all come in off the transformer bank from the three wires.
So momentarily.
Momentarily, for that to have happened, if you walk next door to Jack's right now, they had to have lost power too.
Let's go.
Okay, let's go say hi to Jack. Jack's is cool, guys. We love him.
Generally.
I feel like you need to apologize to the live stream today.
Why?
Because it just keeps going down.
Yeah, Ed, get the live stream back up.
Rocco's already working on it.
Okay.
Did you hear what else brought the live stream down this morning?
Oh, we lost internet. There was that.
We lost internet because Comcast gave us an outage and the UPS that ran the router died.
Oh, shit.
They actually spending some capital.
Look at that. It's a Sunoco station now. How about that shit? Good job, gentlemen. It looks lovely. You want to come paint our place? Did you guys lose power?
Yes, sir.
About 30 seconds came back. No, it wasn't our fault. We just wanted to make sure it was at the mains level and not something internal. And for us to lose 480, 240, and 120,
we were thinking the same
you
thing.
Had to have lost power at the same time. Yeah.
Exactly.
Because our first thought was, damn neighbor kids again.
Yeah,
but no.
Big,
no.
Probably a squirrel again.
Totally.
Pick out their transformer.
See you on TV.
Huh?
See you on TV.
Yeah, you're on a blog.
Oh.
Tell them who you are and what you do.
I can't.
Wait, here. It's classified.
Yeah, it's classified. Told you I'd kill you. Back in a minute.
All right. So you guys are a Sunoco station then.
We are.
That's pretty cool.
Speaking of that.
Yes, sir.
Would you mind if we trim a couple branches on your tree, corner tree right there?
Just no, so I don't
see
mind.
Our sign a little better?
Yeah, I'm totally cool with that.
Okay,
yeah.
Thank you. Might happen on that case.
Okay.
Thanks.
I like the new, but is it?
It's all about exposure.
Is it all new pumps or is it new
no,
signage
pumps,
in the pumps?
The skin of the pumps.
Just
skin.
The skin?
Yep.
What do you do with the old skin? What do you do with the old sign? The old BP sign?
Jack's got that as well. I know, sorry.
Can I have one of the pump skins? And I collect stuff like that.
Yeah,
I'm a nerd.
Yeah, sorry about that.
That's all right.
Yeah, just keep it close for anything else.
Yeah, let me know.
Okay.
So why the change? Why go from BP to Sunoco?
We weren't selling enough gallonage for them.
Oh, okay.
We said, what's your problem with doing with something better than nothing? But apparently,
so that's the one you want to trim?
Yeah, we'll kind of shape it. We'll just kind of.
Okay.
Trim
it up, I
just
trust
a little
you
higher
can do it nice.
Yeah,
make it
yeah,
nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't mind at
just
all.
Just because you can't see if you're coming that way.
I only got one rule.
Right
I only got one rule. You can trim it, but whatever you cut off of it, you got to get rid of. Don't leave
that.
It in the yard.
I knew
don't,
you were
man,
say that.
Don't do that.
All right.
Thank
all
you,
right.
sir.
All right, thank you. I'm making sure we have the...
Oh, you're going to do it with that? How are you going to hold it?
There's the holder right there.
It's not going to work.
Yeah, I wish we had the full
part. No, that's not... The holder here is magnetic.
Yeah. It's slightly works. Yeah.
Jeff's made of aluminum.
The band right here.
Barely. I don't think I'm going to hold it to the weight.
What about the motor housing?
Steel pipe.
Yeah.
Motor housing? No.
There's
some steel bits, but
yeah.
It's not enough to hold it to. The arm's made out of aluminum. It's not
okay.
Aluminum.
Yeah. I'll have to deal with that 1 degree off, I guess.
Well, no, what you do is you put a level on it, and I can adjust it, and you can read the level.
Okay. Yeah, it was a...
But you're going to need a vertical size. Level. This is a horizontal level.
Yeah.
Oh, but you can yep. This to here.
Let me get this point back.
Set that to 90.
Can somebody turn the music off, please?
Okay, this is set to 90. So when we get down to axis 1, or axis 6, we can just measure off of this.
Yeah.
Alright, you ready?
Sure.
Alright, starting mastering. Hang on, I gotta get into. Configure user group. Watch there, don't show the keyboard. It's a super secret password.
Okay.
Okay. Alright, I am in the expert user group. You ready? Setting for dial mastering. Axis 1. All right. so long. God. Mark's right here. This is Mark.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And we'll get there eventually.
Yeah. That's actually the pretty nice thing.
Referred to as the dial mastering as opposed to the EMP mastering. That's actually a good thing for scouts. Yeah, hey Scott. I got a little thing you can make. Well, it's got two parts. No, it's a low priority. Here we go. Coming in. Gotcha. Perfect. All right. Axis 2 is mastered. Going to 3. Come here, dude. This one's up here. You can actually watch it happen. Watch this notch come into alignment with this notch. You want to look straight in from there. It's like watching an eclipse, and it's about as fast. Though it gets faster the further you get out towards the end. Want to hold that camera with two hands, you twitchy fuck.
I know, right?
Boom. Axis 3 is mastered. Axis 4.
Is that this one?
It's this one. Wrist.
Oh, I see.
Axis 4 is mastered. Axis 5.
Pin next to the bolt.
Yeah. But we're not going to master 5 first, we're going to master 6 and then 5. Because that doesn't look right to me. So we're going to sort out 6, which goes this way. Okay. I need a stepladder or something.
Yeah, we got a mark here that says A6.
And I need the guard shield. All three.
Over here.
Alright, I need a stepladder. Fix a giant robot just because the power blinked out for a minute. That's kind of cool.
Should we look into backup batteries for Jeff?
Yeah, at some point. Jeff should have a really good UPS system.
What would it take? Really just the computer, then?
Yeah, it's just a computer.
So at least you don't have to worry about a 480.
Do we have an image of the hard drive?
Okay. Several.
Cool.
In fact, I think that was one of the projects where we were going to make a new one here shortly if we hadn't already.
At this point, I'd get a IDE to compact flash card adapter and...
I want to.
Get rid of the hard drive altogether.
I want to let them build a whole new computer.
The problem is anytime we build a whole new computer, we got to build it in such a way that doesn't damage the old computer, because we still need the old one.
We lost mastering, the power went out. All right, I need that level dingus.
We lost power for about 30 seconds just after 1 o'clock.
Huh?
We're at the tail end of here now. So, and it looks like it was a whole block, so.
That would explain why you didn't know.
Batman, come here.
Yep.
I need you to hold this flat against this plate. It's going to move, but very, very slowly.
Right.
Hey, it's past your Sharpie mark.
Yeah, but this is dead nuts level.
How's it looking from where I'm standing?
Give me a second.
Yeah.
Alright, Batman. Just hold it right on the thing. You good? Okay, mastering axis 5. Mastering axis 6.
It still looks off in the center. Maybe it's because the large square doesn't match the medium square. I don't know. But
the large square is even against the grid of the map.
Just standing from where I'm at, we're a few degrees off. I'm just talking this angle here. This angle here is off.
The level says that block is flat.
Right, but
are the tines level?
Wait a minute. Because the level says the block is flat. The level says the tops of those two bolts are flat within a fraction.
So the square was kind of off when
Mike
drilled it.
The square was a little off when he drilled it.
That's no big deal. It just looks messed up.
These aren't level.
Those aren't level?
These are now, out here, are off just a hair.
And that's where it matters.
They're very nearly level. But that, I want the robot zero, and then we can adjust to taste. And I'm gonna set mastering for the robot at rest. So I'm gonna remaster axis 5.
Okay.
So that it's flat, because we can tweak and code, because the end effector isn't perfectly square. Batman?
Yeah.
Come here. Hold that there. Thank you. What's it want me to do?
Six.
Access six.
You might have to unmaster.
Yeah, I'm going to have to unmaster. Set a... Is there one for unmaster?
Yeah, third one down.
There?
Yep.
What's it say?
Menu selection inadmissible when master is active. So after complete master.
Set up. Okay. I want to unmaster 5.
Okay, 5 is your first one.
Okay. Alright, that is dead, now it's vertical. According to this level. Does anybody else concur? Because it doesn't look vertical to me. Give me a better level.
An almost level.
Yeah, it doesn't look normal to me either. The level says it's level, but I don't say it's level. Yeah, I'm going level off here and here. Because I'm pretty sure this is square.
It looks square.
Yeah, it looks square. So I'm gonna level off the front face and the top plate. And then wherever the pins end up is where the pins end up, and you'll tweak that so.
Yep.
Well, the dial master motor doesn't use that kind of dial. It's a little switch that screws in. It's got a wire to it that plugs it back through.
Well, there's also one that holds the dial.
That's what we're doing right now. That's what it thinks we're doing.
Yeah, that's what we're doing.
That's the best level we got?
No, I just grabbed them real quick just to see what difference
we get. A lot. Squeeze that one there. Do we not have a magnetic one of those?
Squeeze it in the middle.
It's aluminum.
It's aluminum, right? Oh.
Also, Jeff is cast aluminum. This is also
now that looks level to me.
Yeah, I think
so. All right.
The increments might be off on that.
I got it. Throw that piece of shit away. Lies. Alright, mastering robot, axis 5. Axis 6.
Yep.
Robot is mastered. Daddy knows what you want. And these now are level and close to level. They're a little bit twisted this
way.
But not a
lot. The tool said it was straight.
That Scott sucks as a machinist is what that is. Alright, robot is mastered and ready. Put the ladder back where it belongs. Now, they just need to...
Now, can you save the mastering? So
yeah, it's saved. It's saved until the next time the machine freaks out.
So it just loses that always on...
If you completely power it down improperly, like just cut the power, yeah, it's gone.
Now, if we were to properly shut it down now...
Then
and the power gets cut later.
Then it would have mastering.
We should do
but
that.
But mastering is fundamentally the process of telling the robot, this is where you are. Because if you run the robot, you could set mastering to whatever the hell you want. You could master the robot straight up. But it'll think that it's in this position. This is the home position. And if you master the robot not in the home position, you cannot predict what it's going to do. And it gets expensive fast. So at this point, have Windows load the new program in?
It's on the hard drive.
It's on the hard drive, but I need it in the thing. I don't know what its name is.
I needed,
what's the name of the program?
Sol Hanoi.
That's the name?
Yeah, Sol Hanoi.
Where's it at? That one?
There.
Are you sure that's it?
Yeah. Okay. I just loaded it in.
Then
I loaded it in before
going
power
to
outage.
Select. That's your program? I'm dropping your speed down to 10%.
Yeah.
I'm gonna arm your submit interpreter. Clear.
Clear.
Here. If the robot does anything bad, you hit the red button. You hit the red button, the robot stops.
Okay.
Make it go again, you press the top green button.
Top green.
All right. We're now driving the robot.
So this is the first run of the new program.
This is the first run of the new program.
Yep. And this new screen, the program is way off.
Yep. Because if it's coming in,
at
there,
that point, yeah.
Fix it. Try again.
Yep.
Now, this is the other one you need to know. Look up the screen.
Yes.
Okay. The second one over on top. Program.
Program.
Program. Put that in the reset program. Eight. All right. Now, we'll go back one. You got to hold this down until it gets to its first position.
Yeah.
And then you start over. These here, the top one in this screen, see how it says 100, see how it says 10%?
Yeah.
If I come by and I see that over 10%, I'm gonna lay you a beating. Okay.
Chris?
What? They won't matter at this point.
No.
What? Don't lay a beating, man.
Yeah, you know what'll happen? I'll show you a magic trick. We'll be back! Cut it. 1540 hours. This is Mark.
Hi.
Mark, you tell him what you did.
I made laser dance.
Yay!
Sure.
Show him. Look at that. Now it's all loopy and stupid because the galvos aren't tuned yet, and he's only doing this with positive voltage output signals. He's not doing level shifting yet, but it's the very beginnings. Mark made a star.
Yeah.
So, take him through the process. How's this working?
We have an Arduino.
Because there's blinky lights, so of course there's an Arduino for blog cred.
The blinky light's just for debugging.
No, you're doing things with blinky lights.
Oh, okay. That technically, yes.
Now, are you using blanking yet, or is that always on?
It's not blanking yet.
Okay.
It's a closed polygon, so I didn't bother hooking it up.
Okay.
I send a series of points to the Arduino. That goes into a back buffer. As soon as I finish sending those points, it flips into the front buffer and is output through the galvos. The outputting is done through two DUA converters, hooked in parallel and loaded simultaneously along with the blanking line.
Okay.
So we get both galvos and blanking all happening simultaneously.
Cool. How soon can you get blanking working?
10 minutes.
Really?
Yeah.
Let's get blanking going.
Alright.
I want to see an open shape. Even if it's dirty and messy, I want to see simple text or something.
At the moment, because the star is mathematically calculated.
Oh, you're going to have to get creative, but I want some open shapes.
All right.
And we need better galvos. If anybody out there has some laser galvos, especially an XY setup, this man needs galvos.
That would really help.
Yes, because those are antique, archaic, slow shaped galvos. But it's a start, man. It's how it begins, and I'm excited. I'm digging it. Look at this. Chemistry is almost empty. Look at that. Oh, it's coming soon. It's coming soon. We're going to have a chemistry lab in a month. Isn't this great? You haven't seen this yet. You guys gotta see this. Look at this. It's not the shitty brown walls anymore. You see? You can see where the shitty brown wall was, but look at that. It's so much better. It's so much better. I love it. I wonder if Joe's here. Oh, there's trouble. What?
Run.
What are you guys up to? Hi, what you doing?
I'm trying to fix the vectors on this. It all works except the thumb. I need to figure out how to do the thumb to laser cut it.
Vectors.
You
got vectors in your thumb. I gotta get people hanging drywall. You could be hanging drywall.
I'm measuring the building.
Oh, you're working on a model. Yay!
I gotta go bug people. Be back. Nope, 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 nope. Peel that. Put it back down. Peel it, like this.
Uh-huh.
And then it's two separate sheets and way easier to carry.
Nice.
You gotta peel the other end first. Now you've got it.
Beautiful.
And Rachel, 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 come here. Look at that corner. See how it's all cracked out?
Oh, yeah.
You can't ever set them, roll them, flex them on a corner. You can't pick them up by a corner or they break.
Okay.
So let's see where we are on this. I'm curious. He says he flexes the numbers. Selection report. Tyler!
Yeah.
Is the program loaded in?
Not the most recent.
Not the most recent? Okay, I'll wait.
Yeah, we just got back from
the stuff. Okay, that's okay. Once we get this moved, we'll go back to playing a robot. It's closer.
What?
It's closer. It's not there yet, but you're getting close. Let's take it up to full speed and see what it looks like. Tell them what you're making.
I'm making a set of pulleys. They're going on a device that I'm building that's gonna kind of work like a torsion cable.
Okay.
But hopefully with a lot less backlash and a lot less load up.
This is cool. This is You guys will get to see this as it gets done, but it's a pretty nifty project. It's a Bowden drive.
It is a Bowden drive.
It's a thing. It's a Bowden drive. I didn't invent it. But I could have. You'll never know for sure. There's a really cool thing right there, and I can't show it to you yet because it's the super secret project. So you're just going to have to wait. It sucks to be you. Rachel's doing stuff. Difference is Mike knows what he's doing.
Yeah.
Rachel's just burning wood.
I'm actually burning wood. Okay. I think it works.
You think it works?
I think so, but I'm afraid to put my
It's looking better than it ever has. So try it with another test piece and then put the for series piece in. I believe in you. I believe in the Easter Bunny too, so, you know. Does it work yet?
It's been about 2 millimeters on all discs, and I just figured out why it was picking up one higher.
Why?
Negative plus negative is positive. Negative,
yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that was in the program.
Yeah. Cool. Keep rocking.
It's a little low, I need to...
It's a little weird.
Yeah, it's really close though. It's also the shape of the discs themselves can add a little bit of a twist to it.
Try this. This is where it gets messy.
Yeah.
This is where it gets bad.
Yep. This is where I back it down to 3%. But it should...
No! Back it up! Back it up! Fail!
So close.
Oh, that's on there tight, too.
Yeah.
All right, here, hang on. Yeah, you're too low. You're way low.
Yeah. I've already pumped it.
It's tighter than a nun's nasty in there!
Alright. So we're aligned again. Let's go arms and interpreter.
I wouldn't do that.
What?
I wouldn't do that. Okay. You're barely into it.
Oh, there we go.
It's a good thing that table's got a little wonk to it.
Okay, it's still there's got the
a little bit.
Yeah, it's close.
It's really close. I'm digging it.
You want to keep doing this or you got enough shot?
Go ahead. You can do whatever you want. So what do you got going on tonight, Moose?
It's astronomy night.
Okay, so what's going on?
We're going to Dark Sky tonight, and we're going to introduce him to the North American night sky.
Okay. Which is good, because it's the good one. Because the southern sky
like
sucks.
Like the Southern Cross?
Nothing. Yeah, but
they do have
I don't know any of those
they
constellations.
They do have my favorite constellation down there.
What?
Ophiuchus.
Yeah. Okay, so what are you guys doing tonight? What you're going to Dark Sky?
Michigan has some dark sky parks.
Okay,
so
what is a dark sky park?
It's an area where you cannot have any light pollution. That includes restricted cars. You can't bring flashlights. You can't make a fire. It's as close to being in the middle of northern Canada as you can get.
Okay.
While still being in Michigan.
And you're taking the whole gang.
The whole gang. Because most of the people here haven't had the opportunity for real star viewing before.
Okay.
And Batman specifically wanted to have me teach him how to look at the sky.
Cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're gonna do it upright and go through the whole little song and dance when you get out there of what to see and how to see it and how to point. You start at the dip of the tip of the dipper and you go all the way over to the other side.
Okay.
It's too bad you can't vlog it, but it'll be dark.
Well, you guys have fun.
We will.